For thousands of years, humans have seen dreams as mystical or some kind of window into our deeper selves. They've reportedly inspired great literature, like Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. Scientific breakthroughs, like the arrangement of periodic table of elements, and creating hits like Rolling Stones, Satisfaction. Why do we dream? Do our dreams have any meaning or serve any purpose? In this Salvador Dali masterpiece, a woman is woken by a passing bee, and the brain makes up an elaborate dream to explain the buzz and the sting, roaring tigers and the stab of a bayonet. Dali loved his dreams. He said, his best ideas came from them. On this particular painting, dream caused by the flight of a bee around a pomegranate, a second before waking, reflected the common view of dreams in 1944. Before we fall asleep, our brains are a mess of chattering neurons. And all that electrical activity creates chaotic electromagnetic waves. When we fall asleep, activity all across the brain decreases dramatically. But an hour and a half later, something odd happens. The brain roars back to life. Our brain waves look exactly like we're awake. Neurons are talking to each other, sending out signals to move, jump, and speak. That's called rapid eye movement sleep. But a tiny area of the brain stem, called the pons, stops them from actually moving around. Our bodies are temporarily paralyzed, except for our eyes. In rare cases, that spot in the brain stem malfunctions with pretty scary results. This is termed as REM behavior disorder. But for most people, only their eyes act out the dreams. If they were dreaming that they were watching a tennis game, their eyes will go back and forth, again and again. And if they were dreaming that they were climbing stairs, eyes will go up and up. We don't make dreams in the moment of awakening, but we experience them as we fall asleep. When we dream, one area of the brain that's off is the logical judgment filter. And the whole emotional part of the brain lights up like a fire, even now more active than during waking. So that's probably why our dreams are so bizarre and don't make any sense. So it looks like, when we are in a REM sleep, the emotional brain is cranked up, and the reasoning brain is cranked down. And that's certainly how our dreams tend to feel. It looks like we spend about a fifth of the time we sleep dreaming. But most of those dreams are forgotten. It's not easy to remember what you dreamed about. Because during our sleep, we have much lower levels of norepinephrine. That's a chemical messenger that causes us to feel awake and alert. And in the brain, it helps us form memories. Our levels of another chemical, serotonin, plummet too. And it looks like when serotonin release is shut off, it biases the brain to think that whatever it's observing, whatever it's connecting, is important. When we wake up, we are left with a hazy impression of something very profound. In 1899, two books were published that changed the study of dreams. One was by Santiago Ramon Cajal, the father of modern neuroscience. His book spelled out the idea that neurons were the basic units of the nervous system. Experiments by other scientists showed that these neurons communicate using electrical signals. Some scientists still believe dreams are like random electrical storms in our sleeping brains that created equally random and essentially meaningless visions. But the other book, The Interpretation of Dreams, by Sigmund Freud, claimed that dreams was so much more. Dreams were like disguised representations of our innermost desires. One of Freud's earliest supporters, Carl Jung, also believed dreams were messages from subconscious, but they weren't all about our desires. Instead, they contained characters that represented aspects of our inner lives: anxiety, purity, wisdom. In getting away from the concept that dreams were from the gods, or that dreams reflected stomach ailments, that was all progress. But the theory that symbols and dreams have universal meanings is rejected by most scientists today. Dreams of being chased, of having sex, and of a falling are some of the most popular. About 1 in 5 people have dreams of their teeth falling out. Men are more likely to dream about other men, while women dream about both sexes pretty equally. Children are more likely to dream about animals, and only about 5% of dreams are set in location the dreamer doesn't recognize. In fact, most things people dream come from memories of their waking lives. Although everybody knows that our dreams relate strongly to the events that happen during the day, there were no good studies that had shown the incorporation of our waking life into our dreams. It looks like REM sleep doesn't just help us remember, it helps us forget. Forgetting is really important part of learning, and it seems like REM sleep is really important for increasing things that a brain needs to erase, things that it doesn't need to store, so you can incorporate new pieces of information. When we are in that hazy dream state, unbound by reason or consequences, it might be the perfect time to lay the groundwork for insights and breakthroughs. In REM sleep, the brain is creating dreams that are not designed to settle on a single answer, but to help us realize all the possible answers that are out there.